Howdy, howdy, howdy. I know it's late. It's 10 o'clock at night on Friday night, Eastern Standard Time. For you people in California or the West Coast folks, what is that? It's about 7 p.m. and Central people about 9 p.m. But the reason I did this is twice today I got questions that about the best time to start. Okay. Now I'm going to cover something else too. So stick with me. I know some of you are vendors and I got a point to make, but the best time to start. And there's a catch to it though. The best time to start is right freaking now. And you may be going, oh, you're saying that because you get something. No, I have videos on how to start without anything from me. Buying a used car, you can get all that stuff for free. You can get the information for free so that you can get started without spending a dime on anything I have. I've got roughly 800, 900 articles and vendor type articles. Okay. Not like, oh, I went fishing. Let me tell you about it. I've got over 1,000 videos. Now, obviously, I don't expect anybody to go through all that. The nice part is you can search keywords and find what you need. But I got asked, when's the best time to start? But I got asked several times today. And I went, because what's happened is the weather's cooled off a little bit, right? And people are going, well, I just found you. And I'm making this up. I'm just assuming this, but I've been doing this a while and I'm probably right. And they asked me, Ben, they noticed the weather, they noticed, but they just found me and bam, it's fixing to be fall and then winter. And then, well, fall is a phenomenal time. Okay. Phenomenal time. I had a lady yesterday email me and said, all the events I've checked are already booked. You have to book a year before. Yep. We have an article on that, but there's lots of other things, events, there's corn mazes, there's haunted houses coming up. There's Thanksgiving events. You have, if you have a cart, and you may call it a hot dog cart, cause that's the key word, hot dog cart, you've got a mobile kitchen, right? So what can't you do with it? What can't you do? Now I'm not talking about on 5th and Main or 7th and 3rd. I'm talking at the flea market, at the ball fields. We got vendors Monday night that are doing that. We have a Vendors United show that's our private group, and they're doing all these ball fields and ball games. In fact, one of the vendors was at a ball field during the whole show, streaming live his video while he vended. And every now and then he'd come over and talk to us. The point is there's never a bad time to start, ever. Any business. If you want freedom, there's never a bad time to start. Now, here's the catch. I told you there'd be a catch. Unless you're going to start a mediocre business. Now, I want to share something with you today. And I actually took the time and this won't benefit you, this tidbit of information, but it allows me to rant a little bit. But I took the time to pull these numbers, okay? Today, okay, 9 potential new vendor emails today. That's people that aren't vending yet sent me an email. 9. 16 product question emails, either about, hey, does the big dog cart, can I get that with a 11 foot umbrella or something, right? A product question, 16 of those. Some of them were, actually legitimate. I had one from Canada that asked me if I shipped. One service email. That's somebody that wanted something to do with service, and I forwarded that on to our service department. Okay. 5 YouTube comment emails. Basically, if you do a YouTube comment, I get an email, right? I got 5 of those today. 17 current vendor question emails. Now, I'm not telling you that. Hang on. I got a point to this. There's a moral to this story, okay? I'm not telling you this so you go, oh, my gosh, Ben's so busy. I am busy, okay? But I'm telling you this for a reason. 17 current vendor question emails today. 17 of those. That's people that are already vending who said, you know what? I'm going to email Ben. I like that. Doesn't bother me one bit. Love it. Okay. 44 voicemails. Now catch this. 6 of which from current vendors. 6 of those 44 were from current vendors asking questions, right? 17 already current vendor questions by email. That's 23 people, 23 vendors already vending. Most asking, I mean, pretty much, there's not really a dumb question when it comes to this. It's just a lack of information. You don't know the information or whatever. Okay. But these are good questions answered either already answered on the free training blog at learnhotdogs.com or in Vendors United, the member site that I talked about a minute ago, in there, in the private members area. Okay. Questions already answered. Now, 19, okay, of those 23 vendors already on my email list. That means they get an email from me from, you know, maybe once a week. Okay. And somewhere on there tells about Vendors United. Okay. Watch this video. Be around a bunch of pro vendors. Get your questions answered instantly. I mean, you can't post a question in Vendors United and not have 4 or 5 people answer it immediately. Okay. Given their opinion, given their experience, given their whatever. So 19 of the 23 are already on my email list. So they already know about Vendors United. They're completely aware, right? 8 of them actually begging for help. 1 asked, this is no joke, I kid you not, okay? Emailed and said, I really need about a couple of hours of your time. Are you freaking kidding me? It's 10 o'clock at night and I'm still answering emails. Not that I'm complaining, but my point is if you are going to open a business, don't do it if you're going to do it mediocre. And by mediocre means I want other people to do things for me. Invest in yourself. Invest in yourself. The Vendors United Group, the best thing I've ever created. Okay? Now I'm tooting my own horn there. Toot, toot. And it is phenomenal. Phenomenal video. Every day vendors post up videos showing how they do this, how they do that. It is incredible. We've got so much information coming in there, we're having to figure out a way to categorize it. So my point being is I can't spend 2 hours with this vendor answering questions that are already answered because that vendor doesn't want to spend $27 to be in the Vendors United group, right? I'm going to do this real quick. Bear with me. All right, there we go. That's Vendors United. You can learn more about it there. You don't have to join. Just go there and learn about it, okay? But $27. And if you do there's 2 options there. One of them's like $11. I think $11 a month or something. Okay, is what it comes down to, $11 a month. How can you beat that to be around, surrounded? Have you heard that saying about hang around with you know, buzzards and you'll start eating dead meat and hang around with eagles and you'll, you know, soar high or something to that effect. I think I just butchered that to hell and back. But my point is, hang around the people that are working their butts off, doing the right things. Make the Coreys, the Jasons, the Johns, the Jeffreys, the Jesses, the Jeffs, I could literally keep going, but my point is all these folks are taking a little bit of money. Okay. Literally a little bit of money and spending it here. And when I say spending it, it ain't on a pizza that goes away and 24 hours later, you've pooped it out and you got nothing. You are making an investment and it's 100% tax write-off. So you can actually write off because it's education. You can write off the whole thing. And there's no contract. You could go, you know what, Ben, I finally got that call from NASA. I'm going to Mars. I don't need this hot dog vending crap anymore. I'm heading out. Shut off my $27 a month plan. No problem. One email. Nobody's going to ask you, oh, please come back. Nobody's going to do that. Okay. We don't do that. We have no salespeople. So you can do this kind of thing and you can ask some of the people in here. Okay. Right now in the comment section, you'll see there's people in here. Okay. Denver, hang on with me just for a second. I'm going to tell you something that you inspired or your wife, Erin, inspired yesterday. I just want you to know this. There's never a bad time to start a business unless you plan on starting a mediocre one. Unless you plan on starting some half-assed, that's what my papa called it, half-assed. And my dad used to get onto my papa and go, don't cuss around him. And he'd go, I'm talking about a donkey, you know? And he got away with that. It's in the Bible, says ass in the Bible. So anyway, don't do it that way. And fulfill your dreams. A little bit of time and effort spent in educating yourself and putting yourself around the right people will pay off dividends that you can't imagine. I can promise you there are people listening now right here in the comments, and there's people in the group that if you said, is this worth it? I've had people email me and say, I would pay 10 times this a month because the value is there. My goal, though, was not to make it some get rich quick. Oh, I'm going to make some money. I wanted to make it affordable and I wanted it to warrant my time. And that's what I've done. If you want to be successful, whether it's catering, whether it's street food vending, whether it's hot dog vending, no matter what it is, invest in yourself and get access to the information and you'll be successful. Okay. You will be successful, period. This isn't a maybe a get lucky. Oh, it's the lottery. It isn't any of that. Let me put this here real quick. Learnhotdogs.com. I'm putting it in the comments too. You don't even have to type it now. You can just click. Okay. So let me go through these real quick. I want to say hey to everybody that's here. And Jason is here. Tony's here. Jose's here. Tammy's here. DL's here. Kristen. I'm dying to start now, have a cart, but have weeks of waiting to do for licensing. I'd like to know more about that, Kristen. Feel free to call me, okay? It shouldn't take weeks for licensing. Jason, hello, everyone. I'm going to get that same hat. I'd love it, Jason. I'd love it. We just opened Boyd's Tasty Dogs a month ago. Awesome. Awesome. Fall is the best season, chilly dog weather. They sell the best around here. DL, you want a cool hat? Join Vendors United. Jose Pinto, things that you can't do with a hot dog cart let it sit in the garage collecting dust. Big no-no. Chef Jose's right. Okay. You will not be, unless you can make money off of yard art, then it would make you some good money if you could sell tickets to take a picture with your hot dog cart in your front yard. But that'd be it. Hey, Denver, I'm glad Denver says, hey, okay. Denver, if y'all were on the show last night, this is an unplanned show. Okay. But Denver was on the show yesterday evening at 8 PM and his wife, asked about one of the questions in the show was asked about serving a hot dog on lettuce. So I'm doing that tomorrow. Okay. I'm going to do a video. I'll probably broadcast it live, but I'm also going to post a recipe of a chili recipe that I freaking love that you can make easily if you want to make your own chili. Don't have to. It's a pain in the butt if you got to do a lot of it. I'd rather not, right? But if you want to, if you're doing a private catering gig or something and you're making a good lick per head, how's that for a term? Lick per head. Then by all means, either buy a plain Jane chili and jack it up with some extra stuff or make one. Okay. But I'm going to do a video or a blog article or something tomorrow, but it was inspired by Denver and Aaron. And I thank them both for being here. And, you know, it's rare that I come across something new. And I went back through my notes yesterday from the years back. I've never spoken about a lettuce wrapped hot dog. Ever. Okay. It's never been in my notes. So there's, that's cool that, y'all brought that up. Makes me happy. Just purchased your book. Joseph says, Joseph, I hope you're going to love it. Okay. If you don't send it back to me, I'll give you money back. I am in Vendors United DL still waiting on the hat. We just mailed out the last of hats. That's why the hat thing is not in there anymore. We just mailed out the last of hats. Jeremy, you're one of them. Okay. I vend year round. I don't care if it's snowing out or not. The hardest is when it's raining. They see me out there and say, if I'm out there, they will come. Corey knows this as well. Consistency and doing your due diligence pays off. Don't delay starting. If you delay, then you might back out. Join Vendors United. We all help each other. I heard a guy today, he was talking and he said, people lose their job or they change jobs or they're in between jobs. And they, if you ask them, if you know them well, they'll tell you, oh, I hated that job. Well, what are you looking for? One like that. They're moving into the same field. You know, it's like, well, I'm a painter and I was with this painting company or heating and air company or whatever. And now I'm going to try to find a better job at another heating and air company. Good grief. If you have that type A personality, you're an entrepreneur type, then by all means, chase your freaking dream. Chase your dream. Unless your dream's to be a unicorn or something freaking retarded, then don't chase it, right? Save your time. Go do heating and air. But if you have a legitimate goal, and we all have different legitimate goals. Talk to a guy today. He made $61,000 and some change. I don't remember the change part. Okay. Last year net vending. He said, here's what his words were. Okay. That he vended and I have notes somewhere. It's on my yellow pad. And I think my yellow pad's out there. I know this for a fact. It was less than 150 days last year. He vended less than 150 days last year. So that's less than a half of a year. Okay. And he made 61,000 and some change. Don't remember the change amount. Okay. He told me he's never been happier in his life. He said, I've got more freedom. He goes, I know you say you can make $100,000 a year plus or more. And he goes, and I've talked with people. He's talked to Jason before. And he said, I've talked with Jason. I know that it's definitely possible. He goes, I don't care. I'm happy. For the first time in his life, he's happy. That is valuable. So don't set your goals based on, oh, well, Frankenstein wants to make $300,000 a year. I got to be like Frankenstein's. No, you don't. Be like you, because you're perfect. Your goals and your aspirations, if you're a type A entrepreneur type, there is no rule book. There's no rule book. Oh, well, if you're an entrepreneur, you're not successful unless you're making $250,000 a year. Bull crap. Bull crap. I used to make millions. I'm happier now than I've ever freaking been. Ever. I mean, millions. I have more time, more freedom, more everything. Guess what brought me to that party? Hot dogs. Freaking hot dogs. Jason says if they can't afford afford it, they shouldn't be in the business. I agree. We've got over 15 people now in the Vendors United group who ain't even vendors yet. They're learning. They're asking questions. They're getting that information. They're going to start off. You talking about starting off on the right foot? That's the right freaking foot to start off on. Let's see. DL says, I can do hot dogs, tacos, burritos, hamburgers, you name it. I can make it on one of those hot dog carts. Proper prior planning prevents piss poor performance. That's a mouthful on a Friday night. Okay. But thank you. At Vendors United, we have vendors that sell out in a couple hours. One got 125 pounds of lobster. This is no joke. DL's telling the truth. Okay. 125 pounds of lobster made lobster rolls, $14 each, and sold out in an hour. This is in a small town of Missouri. If you were in the Vendors United group, you'd know about it. Okay. I wish I would have done this 20 years ago. Dale, you and me freaking both. You and me both. I wish I'd have done this years ago. I wish I'd have stumbled across it. Got something to show you, and then I'll need help for a new name. I'll show soon. Carl, I'm waiting, brother. Hey, do it now. I'll be 61 years old this year and can do it. Have two families that once I finish my cart wants to hire me for two birthday parties. That's freaking awesome, DL. DL, see, DL hadn't even started yet, and he's in Vendors United. This wasn't meant to be a Vendors United pitch. What it was meant to be is don't start a business start a business anytime. But don't start a business if you're planning on starting a mediocre one. If you're not willing to give it the information to educate yourself, to do your due diligence, then don't do it. Don't do it. Save yourself the time and the headache. And just move on. Go work somewhere else. Go work for someone else. Okay? It doesn't mean you can't come back later. It's not like this vending business is going to go away. They've been doing it for way before I was born. They've been serving hot dogs. We got pictures of vendors doing hot dogs in the 1800s. I think it was 1900s. I think I exaggerated there. I think it was 1900s. My wife and I are doing it. Just wish I would have done it 20 years ago. I'm with you. Freaking awesome. Thanks, Ben. Thank you, Jeremy. Let's see. Past my bedtime. And I have catering tomorrow, about 144. Good job, Michael. Michael Wood, Doug's Dogs. You need to be following him. Anyway, that's it. That's all I wanted to say. I love you. I wasn't trying to be an ass, so don't be upset and don't go, dadgum Ben, he's been an ass. It wasn't meant to be an ass. It was meant to show you what I get daily, okay? And I wanted to share you that nugget of information. If you're not willing to put in the time and the effort, and it's not that much. You know, it's not like, oh, I gotta do this all the time. No. No, you learn it and then you apply it. It's not like there's major scientific improvements on hot dog vending every day coming out and you got to update your software. No, there isn't. Learn this stuff and apply what matters, what will work for you, what feels right to you, and you will be successful. It's hole digging stuff. Okay? I'll talk to y'all later. Thanks.